from Amazon came today, the Canon Selfie CP1200 with the 2.5 inch screen, I believe is what it has. It's got this ungodly sticker on here for some reason on the front cover. It tells that it's saying that it's new. I'm questioning that a little bit based upon the stickers in the box, but right now I'll take the word for it. The packaging that it arrived in was good, but as you can see here, this packaging has had a little few drops at least. So let's take a quick look at the exterior of the box. You can probably pause and read that information telling you about the prints. Pretty much everybody knows about these printers. I've been wanting one for some time. Since I have a Canon digital SLR, I thought this would be nice to go with it. And then we're back to the front of the box. And then to the back of the box. Turn that around. Let you know that it's compatible with Windows 8, EnergySAR compliant, and Max. And then turn that around for the text. It's just information about trademarks and stuff like that there. So, okay. Here's what we got thus far. I'm going to pause this or start a new recording as I open it up just to make it easier for editing. Thank you. Okay. Let's put this baby open here. See what we got inside. Here's some additional information there showing paper and cartridges. Apparently some results on there. Well, you know what this is. This is a basic booklet giving you simple instructions, mostly for licenses, some possible troubleshooting, etc., etc., some legal ease. So we'll put that aside. They're generous with a little bit of paper here. What is it? Probably 5 sheets, I think is what the description said. 5 sheets to give it a test. Oh, this is a registration card for Canon. Never bother to fill those out. They just want your name and address. This is the paper tray. It accepts postcard size, apparently. Okay. Lift this up. And what do we see? We see ink cartridge. AC cable. Probably for the power block, most likely. Let's see if we can find the power brick. Yes. Okay. And then we got the printer itself. There we go. It's wrapped in bubble wrap. The bubble wrap is pretty much busted. It feels pretty flat. It don't feel cushiony. So let's pop this out of the way. See if I can get this open with one hand. More tape. Sorry about that. I didn't know it was off camera there. There we go. Screen, it tilts. And let's see. There we go. Flip that up. Did you see that it tilts? Looks like 45 degrees. And we I go to on, menu, edit, Wi-Fi, some keys for left, right, up and down for copies, and okay, magnify, decrease magnification, back and print. Let's see. That's the front of it. There's where the memory card goes. SD card. Let's see, we got a Kingston lock, a mini USB, and a regular USB. The back side, we got, let's see, a battery unlock and DCN 24-volt. Nothing on the other side except the door to open to put in your ink cassette. So let's open this up. And that's where it goes inside. Okay. Get this plastic out of the way and I'll shut the door back. There we go. And let's put this back down. Check out the back of the unit. That's what we got. It's nice and compact, I guess, for what it does. You could travel with it pretty easily. I bought a case to go with it, but I don't know if I'll use it for this or not. I might use it for something else. I'll have to wait and see. So I'm going to end this for right now. I'm back now. I have the unit plugged in to AC power. I've got the ink in the printer. It loads in the side there, and I put some of the sample sheets into the paper tray. I'm now going to power on the device. Well, let's go. One, two, three. There we go. Hold down for a count of three at least. It's got a symbol wanting paper. Well, I gave it paper. Hold on, let me check the paper tray. I have my password in and it's supposed to be trying to connect now. I don't know if you can see it, but that little circle, there it is going around up there as it's trying to connect. Tell it okay. It's connected to access point. Now, I'm going to stop here because I'm going to use this phone to send a couple of pictures to it to print. And then I'll come back and record when it starts to print because I'm using the iPhone and I don't think I can do both at the same time. But I'm gonna try. I paused the recording and went into my photos and I have sent two pictures to the printer here. I'll pull back so you can watch it. Oh, better. Give it some room. So you can see here. It seems to be doing a very nice job. Of course, I'm only seeing the picture on the screen on my iPhone right now, because I want to be sure. Maybe I only sent the one. Okay, I will pause here and send the other one. No, there it goes. Telling you the printer is busy. You can see the little hourglass up there working. It's a little noisy, but it's not irritating. Now, although the pictures look identical, one was unedited from the Canon digital SLR, and the other one I have altered, photoshopping it. So I just want to see how they both print out.
Let's watch that baby.
And it is complete. I'll pick up the two pictures. And put a comparison side by side. The one on the left has been unaltered. It was just taken with the Canon digital SLR. And this is the one that I photoshopped. I went with more warm tones. And if you'll look, I erased a thermostat around here. If you come over here, you can see the thermostat. And so there we go. Yes, this seems to be a very nice. Okay, it's only been about a week, and I've only used this to demonstrate in one other picture, and I think I have two sheets of paper left, and now all I get is the Canon screen. It won't go any farther. I went online and Googled, and they say to hold down the power button until it goes off, but it won't go off. The only way to get it to shut off is to unplug it. And then they say, once it's been unplugged, press the power button several times once it's completely shut off. And wait 20 minutes. Well, I'm not going to wait 20 minutes this time because I've did it more than once, so waiting 20 minutes. And when I turn it back on, this is all I get. There is no action whatsoever. So I'm going to have to return this unit, and I probably won't get it replaced. Probably just get a refund because I need a printer that I can rely on to print, and I purchased their big printer, Canon's big printer, that's the 9120 or something like that with the 5-inch LCD screen on it. It's somewhat portable, it's not as portable as this, but at least it should work on a regular basis. This would be very upsetting if I had been out in the field and or at a party or something and wanted to share some photos and then just be locked up like that. So I'm going to end this video, and no, I'm not going to recommend the Canon Selfie CP1200 as being a reliable unit. Does it print great photos? Yeah, the photos it print look nice to me. I was really happy with it. And it's relatively easy to use and straightforward. I don't know what has happened that it doesn't want to do anything now. I thank you all for watching, and I hope you liked it somewhat and it was helpful, that maybe you want to check out a different printer. I think there's a newer model out now, but I don't know if it's readily available yet or not. I know an older model, when I was Googling, I think it was a 900 and something. They seem to be having an issue of it too. I don't know if it's just the production lot that's been affected by this, or if pretty much all of them's that, and people have just been frustrated and haven't posted any information. I just don't know. So I'm going to end this, and I thank you for watching, and I appreciate a thumbs up. And if you did enjoy the video or would like, you know, to see future videos, then do please go ahead and subscribe. Thank you, and enjoy your day.